Hello, Las Vegas. So this is a my room. There are two huge beds for two huge people, and this is the view from the window. Actually, they told me it's a striped view. I was expecting to see more mountains, but there are mountains over there. Yeah, there are mountains somewhere over there. The day is something like a bit foggy. You don't know why it's not crystal clear air. And yeah, it's looking like this. It's nice. It's nice. The air conditioning system. These are Fahrenheit degrees, and I'm completely, slightly not thinking in Fahrenheit. 60, it's set to 66 or 67 actually. And actually, this is the roof of probably a casino, and we have a stratospheric tower. Oops, we have to change location. Shot doesn't make any sense. I have to put camera even lower. Sort of. This is the tower. Well, I don't know what's the height of this tower. One, two, three. This is test of microphone. Is it external or internal? This is test microphone. Is it internal or external? So, welcome to Sven Malefic's show. A couple of days in Vegas episodes. Be with me and stay cool. Thank you very much for your attention. Mwah. Welcome and goodbye. How's it going, mates? You're right? Oh, the airplane is flying. Come to daddy. Where is it? Oh, it's landing. It's over there, I see. It's landing somewhere over there. Fucking hell, why it's not sharpening? Yes, thank you, camera. You are so fast.
Left for Espen. Thanks.
There's actually flying aircraft over there. Let's follow him a bit. It's landing. Landing aircraft.
So it's actually getting windy. Right here, right now, in Las Vegas.
Hello there, it's 25 past 8 p.m. and I think it's time to go somewhere. Yeah, I know what you mean. It's the middle of night and I'm actually spent most of the day just sleeping after last night, and well, I just finished a silly video which is like a composition of time lapse when I've been shaving myself, and this is also a microphone test, so don't worry, it's a comedy channel and comedy is the best way to talking about very important stuff, but it's also advocating free speech and open-mindedness. So thank you very much for your attention, and I really appreciate you just jumping into this channel, even there are just only a few people, maybe two, maybe one. That's really absolutely amazing. It's amazing, like the rest of the life we will be living together for a moment, not for too long. The life is gonna be ended, terminated by biological reasons. We understand that there is no life without death. We have to die. And anyways, don't worry, be happy. And I will see you later.
Hello. How's going, mates? I'm here just testing the light and environment, making something like test shots in terms of production of my video, which will be just a simple self-advertisement. I will be talking about my skill set, by my interest, what I'd like to do, what is important in my maybe not career, but about things I really like to do. And basically this is just a test video, so don't worry. Now I'm going to switch off a recording and have a look if it's cool or not. Welcome again, this is another test. I'm just talking to the camera. And well, it's a test with computer screens behind me, on television, two laptops, and my iPad. They are all somehow important in my process. So basically this is just another test, so don't worry if something is creepy or strange. I'll just make a couple of approaches. So just testing something like wider angle or closer angle, and basically it's for just a training purposes, so nothing serious. Also like a microphone test, and it's pretty much cool, and thank you very much for your attention. Thank you.
I just found someone left. This is a dancing.com. I don't know what this is. It the gift? Well, it's a strange thing. It's coming. It's over there. Yeah? So.
Thank you. Bye. I'm sorry, guys. I meant guest, not victim. I still have trouble since the incident. Okay, there's no incident. Just fun to say that. These are off-roading vehicles, which we're not going to do any of on this tour. We have a tour that's 128 miles of dirt. There's part of 45, part of 102 over rocks and shells and ledges. There's 30 of these in the world, and they're all pink Jeep. They all belong to us. We custom designed them to do that. And they have 6.7 turbo diesels, heavy-duty transmissions, axles, oversized tires, and wheels. The important thing you need to know about that visitor center, it is the last real live bathroom that has plumbing that you're going to see take you back to your hotel. As we go around the loop, there's those little brown buildings with a hole-in-the-ground park service pit-style toilet with no running water and usually pretty cold seats. I love it. It's on public land, but the city did not build this. So the only reason I figure this happened, somebody in the airplane club owns or works for a paving company. I've never seen a paved runway set up like this for model airplanes. And they've got old cable spools that they use for tables, and they have taxi strips and a windsock, and it's just cool. I've never owned a model airplane, probably never will, but it's cool. There's a guy there flying a plane now, at least one person. Right here on the right, how cool are some people leaving? They've been more of a bit down there flying, I guess. How cool is that? A runway. They taxi out and take off and everything. I just love that. We started out on Las Vegas trip at 2,000 feet. We're already about 3,000 feet up. I can tell that because I have a long, spiky green leaf plant on the left that's starting to show up here. Is Mojave Yucca. Starts going at around 3,000 feet, goes to about 4,500. Mojave Yucca, Native American, found that root to make soap. Makes a nice sudsy soap, wash anything in it, wash your hair in it. Your hair comes out silky smooth, even a day. Go dangerous. Lots of expensive hair products occasionally see yucca extract or yucca. The leaf is entirely made of fiber. It looks like a celery thread. Stronger than a steel wire by weight. Used for anything you need a fiber for. Sewing thread, fishing line, braided for bow and arrow, floor mat, sandal, basket, strong rope. Always available. Grows an edible flower. A fruit about the size of a golf ball with a sitting skin. So traditionally they roast it up, sliced down, it goes really high. It resembles this, goes close to the ground as a blue-green leaf. You can make soap. The texture is sparse, the flavor is kind of sweet, potato, and bitter. So on a western Grand Canyon tour, well, Wallaby Reservation, ask an elderly Wallaby lady if they still do it. She says, yes, we do. She even makes cupcakes out of it. Off to the right, at the Calico Basin, part of that belongs to the park. A lot of private land up in there. There's horse ranches and horse boarding stables. There's Arabian horse ranch up there. Imagine a horse ranch, and that is the backdrop for your horse ranch. It's fake. They would have faked that for a TV show or a movie. Couldn't really look that good, but it actually does. Pretty cool. Our first stop's going to be a visitor actually seeing a Joshua tree.
Which one is it?
Well, it's got short green. Thank you. We saw Mojave yucca, that's the long green leaf. Higher up we'll see banana yucca, the blue green leaf. Traffic sign, tortoise crossing. How cute is that? It's Mojave, man. Time to get out and everything. So at 10 minutes after, I'll drive right up here and pick you up in the same place I dropped you off at. But I gotta go down below, way down there and park. Okay, restrooms are on the left just before you go in up there. And definitely check out the area behind the visitors.
Head Peak, I'm guessing, Calico Hills, if I'm not wrong, and see the land turn upside down, which is older, Telfo Head Peak or the Calico Hills, there's the question. Nice today. Looks like on the Tenerife a little bit. Thank you.
rope to climb. The rope's just a safety. Then again, doesn't look like Calico's open yet. Nope, it's not. Darn it. I do like to stop here, but we haven't been able to for about a month now. We'll stop a little farther up. Our first stop is going to be kind of a photographic stop. Our second place we're going to stop, we're going to get up on some rocks. But I got people over there in the climbing area. Can't stop right here. Nobody actually up on the wall. Not that I can see. Okay, right straight over there, just slightly ahead, was a whole bunch of people. The base of that flat, dark colored area. They climb that vertical wall a lot. That's a real popular climbing area right over there. People look really small, and I can't stop and point them out because there's no stopping right here. Right straight across from us right now, I see a whole bunch of colors there. Little bitty people. Well, actually, they're full-size people, but they look little from this distance. There's a lot of other areas. Across from us wearing a blue, he's wearing blue, going up the wall over there, straight across from me.
Yeah, I just got about halfway up the wall.
If he had moved a little bit, he's just kind of still now. He was moving earlier, makes him easy to see.
Some stones in the middle of nowhere.
Thank you.
some of the flora. Get you guys up on the wall, that you just vertical wall climbing, all kinds of fun things. I'm trying to direct you to our right over the cloud, just slightly ahead. But unless you see anybody on them, with the cones and everything. You're right directly across to the right, the island wall. This is such a beautiful view, take a picture of you guys or whatever. White, red, white, and against the blue sky we have a sphinx.
Yes, absolutely.
Some people say elephant, but I like the sphinx.
I like sphinx. The sphinx, yeah.
That's kind of the best one, I think.
Yeah.
The colors are just phenomenal right here. I get a picture of you guys and all that behind you and everything, all that color.
And the moon.
Yep.
And the moon.
Do it, Trish. He won't sleep.
Of stone here.
Head for the lift. We're done by Anasazi, which is a predecessor, like ancestral football. It's a predecessor to the modern Indian we have today. And no modern tribe says they're directly descended from the Anasazi, except the Hopis. Then they say we don't know anything about them. The Anasazi never had a written language, so there is no actual record other than the pottery shards. Structures and things like that, experience, whatever you find, but you have to interpret it. Pictographs are done by cave paintings, they're done by stain. That's a really kind of silver gray color, has an orange area. This is a much wetter area. And when storms come through, they can eat minute quantities of magnesium and iron out of the rock, mix it with clays and maybe go around the storm, marks the wall. A lot of iron is marking the stone. I have seen horses around here become extinct and show up to work.
That's a problem.
Trips again, if I get to chew it. I bet you from getting hungry, then we've got to keep your energy up and just keep walking.
about a half a cup. It's kind of bitter. Should have some honey for it. But boy, it dried up everything, and you got drifty. So it's got some punch. Food source out here. There's only 5 handprints. Used to be 6, but the rock on the right fell off several years ago. You cannot interpret these. They didn't have a written land snows, it'll melt away. Fairly defensible. That's the only decent way in.
Pick the fruit. So we'll see it all over the mountains, and all of a sudden it's gone. People make jams, jellies, preserves, syrups, marmalades. Pretty much every gift shop's gonna have little jars of prickly pear syrup. Place on the way to Zion has a little gift shop. Makes their own ice cream, the prickly pear ice cream when it's in season. Kind of cool. I wasn't that great, but I had to try it. Think about bears, though. Bears love everything sweet. Honey nuts, flower petals. They love these pawpaws. Cartoon movie Jungle Book. Baloo the Bear, world's coolest bear. Voice of Phil Harris. Teaching Mowgli to me.
Kind of a cool story. Cool about his book.
I have to come back. So, bye-bye.
The tree left of the bridge, which doesn't really have leaves on it yet. That's wild fruit.
Did
I pass it too far?
Yeah.
It's can't see
it's,
anymore?
No, it's quite a ways back now.
Oh. Look at the size of the ears on those things.
Oh, they're gorgeous.
Way bigger than a white-tailed Midwestern deer would be.
Fantastic.
And look at the little one over there.
Yeah, one in the lead looks like rabbit ears. I can see on a rabbit or something. They're so big.
So sweet.
That's a young one right there.
Yeah.
That's mom and two fairly young ears.
Yeah.
But mom's got some really big ears. Well, we got mule deer.
Hey.
All right.
They're pretty well camouflaged.
Yeah. Beautiful animals.
Yeah.
And there's a young one down there, doesn't it? Well, that's a young buck. Still got a little rack on. They're all bucks.
Yeah.
I'll be darned.
That's unusual.
Yeah, so very.
Not even Friday night.
Heading for the, I guess they can't go to the Elks Lodge. They're not that big.
Yeah, that's right.
Wow.
How does it work? Anyone is falling down?
How is it operating? Pretty much. Sounds like... I'm so tired waiting. So I guess it's gonna be very quick. Oh no. Come on. Why? Something wrong? Okay. This is going, doesn't make any sense.
See? Something?
Nothing's going over there.
Nothing is moving.
There is nothing moving.
Nothing is moving over there, so...
What's a pointless video?
25 per second.
Sorry, 25 seconds per second.
Time is, as you can see, reflections killing everything. Reflection kills everything. Why there are so many reflections? 5:29.
So tired. Hungry as a bitch.